baby in the belly.
Meet our first Ouch Baby family, Remy Carter and Beau William, and their mum and dad, Lisa and Sam.
Who's in there?
A baby sister!
And this is Carrie, his dad Mickey and mum Susie.
Where's the baby? Ah, he rubbed mummy's belly. Ah.
Both families are waiting for their new arrival.
It's exciting, isn't it?
Every baby starts as a tiny single cell deep inside a woman's uterus.
When a woman is pregnant, that cell divides and keeps dividing, creating billions of cells which make up the baby's bones, organs, in fact, their whole body.
What I'm enjoying most about being pregnant is the fact that we're expanding our family, that Carrie's going to get a brother or sister. I'd say my least favourite things about being pregnant are definitely the fact that I'm much more tired now. And also the fact that you have to go for a wee constantly. The baby's position changes and such, and then as the baby gets bigger, it presses down on your bladder.
Susie and Lisa's babies have been growing very quickly in their bellies.
After only 4 weeks, their baby's heart and lungs begin to develop, along with their limbs and nerves. But incredibly, baby is only the size of a poppy seed.
By week 9, the babies are developing eyes and hands. They can even sense touch, but they're still only the size of a cherry.
At 34 weeks, baby is the size of a melon and is well on the way to being fully developed.
He can't see her. Because there's a cover.
There's a cover.
The baby's the cover.
Remy Carter and Beau William can't hear her yet, but they can feel their baby sister kick.
It's normally in the first 16 to 25 weeks of the pregnancy that a mum will first feel her baby move.
And I thought the baby move.
These will feel like butterflies, but as baby grows, mum will feel kicks and stronger movements.
Who do you give cuddles to?
Mummy and the baby.
Just like us, babies need to eat, but inside mum's womb, they get this through an organ called the placenta.
The placenta develops within a mother's womb during pregnancy. As well as providing oxygen and nutrients, it also removes waste products from baby's blood. Everything goes in and out through the umbilical cord, which comes out of the baby's belly button.
It's amazing that your belly button was once your mouth and your bum all in one.
Yes, Aunt.
Catch our next video when we'll have a peek at our Ouch babies as both families go for an ultrasound scan. Peek at baby!
For both our Ouch baby families, one of the most exciting times during a pregnancy is having an ultrasound scan.
And today, we're joining them.
You can hear both our babies' heartbeats. It's a pretty unique sound.
It's a good sound, isn't it?
Yeah, very reassuring.
Your heartbeats are an average of 60 to 100 beats a minute.
A baby's heartbeat is normally a lot faster, at over 110 beats a minute.
Why do we have to smear jelly all over Susie's belly?
So the jelly makes sure you have a really good contact. If you don't use jelly, you get a very poor picture.
An ultrasound scan works by sending sound waves through the uterus, and these waves bounce off the baby as echoes, and it's these echoes that are turned into an image on the screen.
So all the sound waves will hit different tissues at different speeds and reflect back at different rates. The image is always in black and white in an ultrasound scan. If you're seeing black, you're seeing fluid.
During pregnancy, babies are surrounded by amniotic fluid, which protects and nourishes them.
And when you get to bone, it looks very bright and white. And that round circle there is the baby's stomach. And when anything is hollow, and the baby's obviously swallowed fluid from around the baby into its tummy, you'll see it, a little black circle on the screen, and that looks very normal.
And the babies are swallowing the fluid the whole time that they are bathed in?
Absolutely, so they wee and they swallow. And they wee and they swallow.
Yummy.
So yeah, so that's what happens inside.
Time to see how Lisa's scan is going.
So Lisa's getting extra scans to make sure that her baby is growing really well. Christine, are you measuring the head, is that right?
We tend to measure the head, the tummy and the leg, and those measurements will show us how well the baby is developing. This is a section through the tummy. Baby's stomach is here. It actually looks like a little smiley face on
it. It does.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think, Madison? You're seeing your newest baby sibling.
really happy.
Yeah?
It's nice to see her.
You stick your tongue out?
Yeah. Just thinking about what she's going to look like when she's born.
See what happens in our next video when both our ouch babies are born.
So what do we say might be happening tomorrow?
A baby will come out.
Okay, and how do you feel about that?
Baby's birth.
After 9 months in mum's belly, both babies' mums are in early stages of labour.
What do we say might be happening tomorrow?
A baby will come out.
Okay, and how do you feel about that?
Happy.
Happy.
Every contraction is my uterus tightening, and it means the baby's head is coming down, which is really good.
When a mum goes into labour, she will start having contractions.
This is when the muscles in the uterus start to tighten to help push baby out.
At the moment, they're kind of at the point where I'm getting one every 15 minutes and they're lasting about 30 seconds. So it's just important to make sure I breathe through them when I have them, and also to make sure I keep bouncing on the ball. Bouncing on the ball is good just because it's really comfortable, opens my pelvic outlet and lets gravity assist the head coming down, which is the most important thing as well. So we're just waiting.
Lisa has also gone into labour.
Oh, can you see that a little bit? That's her moving in there. Just feeling excited to meet baby.
A few hours later, Lisa and Sam had their baby at home with the help of their midwife, Mary.
Congratulations. Can I say hello? Lisa, how are you feeling?
Really happy.
For newborn babies, skin-to-skin contact like this is really important as it can help regulate baby's heartbeat, breathing, body temperature, and it helps them to bond with their parents.
Our other ouch baby family have travelled to the hospital to have their baby.
Hi, baby boy.
Susie gave birth minutes after they arrived.
He's looking very healthy. Yeah.
He's been feeding continuously. That first milk that comes out of the breast, the colostrum, isn't just food. It's also got antibodies that make up the immune system. And that first gulp he has is going to be really important for him.
It's important for new babies to get weighed soon after birth.
3.51 kilos.
Oh, she's more than we thought. She's 3.62.
Here we go.
They are both around the average weight for a newborn, which is about 3.4 kilograms, or the same as 3.5 bags of sugar.
Hey, boys, how you doing?
And now both our ouch babies have very important visitors.
So your sister's looking pretty cute, isn't she?
Yeah.
Who's this?
The baby.
The baby. We got kisses for the baby.
In the next video, we find out our ouch babies' names. Baby's first week.
Last time, we saw both our ouch babies being born.
They now both rely on mum's milk for nourishment, but during pregnancy, they relied on something else. The placenta and the umbilical cord provided oxygen and nutrients which help them grow. After a baby is born, the umbilical cord is cut. Today it's done by dad, and that's what makes the baby's belly button.
That's the umbilical cord.
Yes, that's where the placenta is cut.
And what happens now to that?
In about a week, it'll hopefully drop off.
So my parents kept the clamp and the bit of umbilical cord as a souvenir, and for Dr. Chris as well.
After baby is born, the placenta also leaves mum's uterus. It's a gross alert!
This is placenta here. So this is the umbilical cord. That's where it's cut. This is the sac where the baby has lived, attached to the umbilical cord for the last 9 months.
A few hours after birth, the midwives do a series of routine checks on our ouch babies to make sure they're healthy.
Making sure the head is the right size, make sure that the heart sounds are good. The heart sounds.
I know.
Making sure the eye reflexes are there.
That's it. Oh, good.
We have also checked the baby pees and poos.
And with that important matter out of the way, it's time for Carrie and his new baby brother to go home.
Hey!
Our other ouch baby is having a very important party.
Today's the naming ceremony. It's usually a week after they're born.
Grace Marie, Mariah Olua, Margot Ray.
Wow, that's a lot of names.
She will be known as Margot Ray for short.
Mickey and Susie have also now decided on a name.
Joseph.
Well, hello, Joseph.
And Joseph has a community midwife visiting. One of her first jobs is to weigh him.
You may remember the midwife weighing Joseph as soon as he was born.
3.51 kilos.
Let's see how much it's changed.
So Joseph weighs less now. This is common in newborns, and he'll gain this weight back as he grows.
Carrie wants to get involved too.
I see a future doctor.
Next up, Joseph is having a heel prick test. This involves taking small spots of blood from the baby's heel.
The reason for the test is to test for 9 different medical conditions. All of these conditions are rare, but they are quite serious.
With the test completed, Joseph is back in Mum's arms.
And what's Margot Ray up to?
Her umbilical cord has come off.
Dr. Xand, maybe you want one of these?
Add it to the Ouch collection.
Check out our next film, when we'll be looking at our babies' food and their poos.
Babies' food to poo.
Today we're looking at what our Ouch babies are eating and what comes out the other end.
Both our Ouch babies are being fed with their mum's milk. Through this milk, babies are able to pick up tastes of things their mum has been eating and drinking. And this means babies get used to different flavours from a very early age.
As babies' tummies are about the size of a walnut, they feed frequently.
Like an every 2 to 3 hourly thing, and obviously more if you need it for comfort as well.
And how long on average does it take to feed Joseph?
Sometimes he could be on 20 minutes, and other times he could be on over an hour.
He feeds a lot more in the evening, just and you produce more milk at night as well.
When you're older, it's usually very easy to burp if you need to, but babies need a little help.
Burping helps to get rid of any air that Joseph might have swallowed during feeding. Not being burped can cause air to get trapped, which can be very painful, and we don't want that.
And today, both our Ouch babies have some very important visitors bearing gifts.
That's it? Oh, wow!
Can you open it? Okay, thank you, Bobby. This is an official Operation Ouch Baby Grow. There are only 2 of these in the world. Here.
And we're not leaving the big brothers out.
Here is your Operation Ouch sticker. As you know, what goes in must come out. And that means babies can produce a lot of pooey nappies.
You could change his nappy up to sort of 12, 13 times a day, at least at this stage. It's just constant pee-poo, feed pee-poo, basically.
You must be really busy.
Absolutely.
Let's get this nappy changed then.
Have you ever changed a nappy?
No.
Well, you are about to learn how.
Let's have a look. Has Joseph done a poo? Has Joseph done a poo?
She's still healing where her umbilical cord was cut, making the belly button. So that's all sealed up with a bit of wee. Luckily, no poo.
Joseph's done a poo! And look at the colour!
This might look very different from your poo, and it also changed a lot from baby's first poo, which was called a meconium poo.
This is what you'd expect from a baby's first nappy.
It's this unusual colour because it's made up of things like amniotic fluid, bile, and mucus that the baby would have swallowed in the womb.
Baby's poo colour changes from black to yellow over the first few weeks because mum's milk changes as baby grows. Also, because their digestive tract matures.
Now, which way round does it go? Do you boys remember?
That way.
Okay, ready? She's been amazingly good. How did I do, boys?
100 out of 10.
100 out of 10. Mum, are you happy?
Very happy.
All done. And Joseph is very happy.
Check out our next film, where we'll be looking at the world for our Ouch baby's eyes.
Baby's senses.
Today we're joining our Ouch babies at home to understand how they see and feel the world around them.
At birth, babies can only see about 5% of what you can see. The rest is grey outlines, and they can only make out faces at about 30 centimetres away.
At the moment, things are still a little bit blurred.
But babies are attracted to strong black and white patterns like the ones in these baby books.
So these were given to us by the health visitor. It's what they can see at this point.
Look at that,
Joseph. Someone's sticking their tongue out.
Yeah.
So we do this every day.
These patterns also help babies' eyes to develop their focus.
Nice way to get Carrie involved as well.
Newborn babies can't see colour, as it takes time for certain cells in their eyes to fully start working.
By 2 months, babies can tell red and green colours apart, and a few weeks later, they can also tell blues and yellows.
By 6 months, babies' vision has more or less fully developed.
Newborn babies have an excellent sense of smell. As they cannot recognise their mums by sight, they can recognise her by smell. They even start using their sense of smell when they're still inside mum's tummy.
Newborn babies are also equipped with reflexes that help to protect them.
One of these reflexes is the mammalian dive reflex. Infants up to 6 months old who are submerged in water will naturally hold their breath.
Another amazing reflex is the grasp reflex.
She'll automatically grip
my finger. She's doing it really hard. Now, she doesn't have to think about that. It's just a reflex. And scientists think that that evolved to help babies cling to their mothers. Now, babies at this age also have another reflex called the startle reflex or the morrow reflex. If we just make her think she's falling, but just pick her up and drop her like that, you can see her arms spread out. And that's one of the reflexes it's really important to check when babies are born and make sure it's working well.
Our Ouch babies have also been learning new skills. Tummy time each day helps babies to build muscles so they can eventually support themselves.
So soon he'll be sitting up, he'll be rolling over, eventually crawling, and then walking.
We've been so lucky to follow our two Ouch babies from inside their mum's tummies to their first weeks in the big wide world.
Yeah, baby Joseph.